بسم الله، السلام عليكم and welcome to Amatullah Green and another episode of Let's Study the Quran Together. And today we're doing Friday edition. بسم الله. We are doing Surah Al-Kahf and we're going to do a quick recap from last Friday. Surah Al-Kahf, there are four main stories in this blessed surah. There might be a fifth story, but it's only mentioned quickly. The people of the first one is Ashab al-Kahf, the people of the cave. Ashab al-Jannatain, the two men, the owners of the garden. Musa alayhi salam with Khatar, the story of Musa alayhi salam. Dhul Qarnayn, and the story of Dhul Qarnayn. And this surah was revealed in Mecca, so it's Makkiyah. And the Sheikh said that every surah that contains stories in the Quran is Makkiyah. These stories are meant to be a guidance for us. Allah says in Surah An'am, verse 90, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَى اللَّهُ فَبِهُدَاهُ مُقْتَدِي. These are the ones that Allah guided, so follow their guidance or their footsteps. And it was narrated many hadith on this, the benefit of this surah. Some are sahih, authentic, and some there are differences on it, on them, so ikhtilaf. One is whoever memorized the 10 first verses of Surah Al-Kahf will be protected from Dajjal. So that's an authentic one. And in another narration, it says the last 10 verses. So whether you memorize the 10 first verses or the 10 last, you will be protected, inshallah, from Dajjal, Antichrist. And there's another hadith that whoever reads Surah Al-Kahf from Friday to another Friday, Allah will light will shine brightly for him till the next Friday. And he said this hadith is Hassan. And Muslims should make effort in reading this blessed surah. You can read it from Thursday night as it counts as Friday. If you miss it, read it later on any other day. That's what the Sheikh said. And there was a companion called Usaid or Usaib, I'm not sure, Ibn Hudayr, I think, that the angels came to listen to his recitation of Surah Al-Kahf. But the Sheikh said, this is not unique for this surah only. Angels do listen to all Quran recitations. So, inshallah. That's the recap from last time. I've got my sticky notes here. And we are going to start, inshallah, our beloved Sheikh. And this is, by the way, ta'amulat. So, it's just reflection. And it's not detailed tafsir. We will have detailed tafsir, I believe, when we reach Surah Al-Kahf, inshallah. So this is, of course, just reflections on the surah. Bismillah, let's go.
أول هذه القصص هي قصة أصحاب الكهف الذين سميت السورة على الحال التي مروا بها.
So the first story is, of course, أصحاب الكهف. أصحاب الكهف, the people of the cave, which are named after them. So the surah is called Cave, the Cave, Al-Kahf, which is named of them. So he's going to tell us the first story, inshallah. And I'm just going to take notes and then stop and explain to you guys, inshallah.
أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَيْ أَحَسِبْتَ أَحَسِبْتَ أن أصحاب الكهف والرقيم كانوا من آياتنا عجبا، أي ليس هذا هو العجب الوحيد، وإنما هناك آيات أعظم منها، وإنما هي من ضمن الآيات التي تدل على قدرة الله تبارك وتعالى وعلى سعة رحمته سبحانه جل في علاه. وزبدة هذه القصة أنه في ذلك الزمان.
He said, first thing first, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. He's saying, Allah started this surah by saying, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ, do you think that, are you amazed by the story of أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ? There are so many miracles and so many عجاب, miracles in the Quran, and آيات, verses in the Quran. So this is just one of them.
والله أعلم, يعني متى كان هذا الزمان؟ قيل قبل مبعث عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام وقيل بعد رفع عيسى صلوات ربي وسلامه, ولكن في النهاية هي من قصص بني إسرائيل. قصة أصحاب الكهف هي من قصص بني إسرائيل. وعندما نقول قصص بني إسرائيل, فإسرائيل هو يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام, كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى, ومن ذرية إبراهيم وإسرائيل. فإسرائيل هو يعقوب، اسمه يعقوب واسمه إسرائيل، كما أن النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد سموه أحمد، والمقفي والحاشر صلوات ربي وسلامه والعاقب، كذلك يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام اسمه يعقوب واسمه إسرائيل.
Okay. He said the story, and Allah knows best. He said it's said to be before Isa alayhi salam. So some people, some mufassirin say it's before Isa was a prophet, sallallahu alayhi salam, and some say after he was taken up to Allah. You know, after Rafa, but Rafa'ahu Allah, when he was taken to Allah, rising up to the heaven. So it's, some say it's either that before Isa alayhi salam or after Isa. What there is no doubt about is that this is the story of Banu Israel, the people of Israel, and he's saying Israel is the name of Yaqub alayhi salam. And he took a verse, I hope I can find that, wa min dhurriyatihi. Ibrahim Israel, I think it's Surah Safat. He said, Allah says, how do we know that Yaqub is Israel? Surah Safat, where are you? ومن ذريتي. I forgot the ayah that he said, but I think it's somewhere here. In Surah 2. I hope we're studying together, so bear with me. وباركنا على إسحاق وتركنا سلام على إبراهيم. I can't find the verse. Salam. I'm sure it's in Surah Safat. Let me read the verse again.
رحمته سبحانه جل في علا. وزبدة هذه القصة أنه في ذلك الزمان والله أعلم يعني متى كان هذا الزمان، قيل قبل مبعث عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام، وقيل بعد رفع عيسى صلوات ربي وسلامه، ولكن في النهاية هي من قصص بني إسرائيل. قصة أصحاب الكهف هي من قصص بني إسرائيل، وعندما نقول قصص بني إسرائيل فإسرائيل هو يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام، كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى ومن ذرية إبراهيم وإسرائيل، فإسرائيل هو يعقوب اسمه إسرائيل.
من ذرية إسرائيل وإسرائيل وممن اشترينا هذه إذا تتلى عليه آيات it's not in Surah Safat, it's in Maryam. Sorry, I'm taking your time, but it's in Surah Maryam. It should be Surah Maryam. طه Maryam in between. كهف ومريم in between here. Yeah, it's in. I thought it was in Safat. There. الحمد لله. Finally. ومن ذرية إبراهيم وإسرائيل ومن من هدينا. ومن ذرية إبراهيم وإسرائيل. إسرائيل يعني يعقوب. All that time for this verse.
يعقوب واسمه إسرائيل كما أن النبي محمد
صلى الله عليه وسلم. So يعقوب is also called إسماعيل إسرائيل. The same way our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is called أحمد.
الله عليه محمد سموه أحمد.
أحمد.
والمقفي. والحاشر. صلوات ربي وسلامه والعاقب. كذلك يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام اسمه يعقوب واسمه إسرائيل. وقصص بني إسرائيل هي قصص ذرية يعقوب. لما نقول قصص بني إسرائيل يعني قصص ذرية يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So when we say قصص When we say قصص بنو إسرائيل, the stories of the people of Israel, it means the children of يعقوب عليه السلام.
وذرية يعقوب ما شاء الله كبيرة جدا. وجل الأنبياء من ذرية يعقوب. جل الأنبياء من ذرية يعقوب. يوسف, موسى.
And all the prophets come from يعقوب عليه السلام. They are the children of يعقوب عليه السلام.
عيسى, زكريا, يحيى.
داود سليمان يحيى عيسى زكريا
أيوب جل الأنبياء هم من ذرية هم من بني إسرائيل وإذا قال الله تبارك وتعالى عن موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام أنه قال لقومه وإذ قال موسى لقومه يا قوم اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ جعل فيكم أنبياء
جعلكم ملوكا
وجعلكم ملوكا وآتاكم ما لم يؤتي أحدا
من العالمين.
من العالمين.
He said all the prophets came from Ya'qub عليه السلام, and that's why Allah said, وإذ قال موسى إن سورة مائدة وإذ قال موسى لقومه يا قوم اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ جعل فيكم أنبياء. Remember the blessings Allah gave or bestowed upon you when He made you here. This is the verse if you want to look up it. It's سورة مائدة page 20. وإذ قال موسى لقومه يا قوم اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ جعل فيكم أنبياء. The blessings of Allah, one of them being that He made amongst you anbiya wa ja'alakum muluka, and they had kingdoms too, like Sulaiman and Isa and Sulaiman and Daud.
Taqil inna bani Israel kan tasusuhum al-anbiya kullama mata nabi qama nabi.
So the people, the children of Yaqub, they were all prophets. When a prophet passes away, another one comes.
Ya kun akthar min nabi fi waqtin wahid kama hasala li Zakariya
wa Yahya. And sometimes Zakariya, I think, yeah, and Yahya. And sometimes there were more than one prophet at one time. So sometimes you had Zakariya and Yahya.
Musa wa Harun.
Daud and Sulaiman, they were prophets at the same time. So sometimes there is more than one prophet at the same time. So these are the stories of the children of Ya'qub, and it's said to be before Isa alayhi salam, and it's also said to be after. And he said, whatever it is, if it was before Isa alayhi salam or after, it doesn't matter. What matters is al-ibra, the reflection and the story, that we, the message that we take from these stories.
التي تؤخذ من هذه القصص ومنها هذه القصة المباركة. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى عن هؤلاء أم حسبت أن أصحاب الكهف والرقيم كانوا من آياتنا عجبا. أولئك في ذلك الزمن كان الملك كما ذكر أهل التفسير كان الملك كافرا ويدعو إلى غير عبادة الله تبارك وتعالى ولهم آلهة كثيرة من دون الله تبارك وتعالى يدعونها من دون الله تبارك وإذا اعتزلتموهم وما يعبدون من دون الله فكانوا يعبدون من دون الله تبارك وتعالى آلهة أخرى.
So this story is about, like the Mufassirin said, he said about a Malik, a king who was kafir, he was he was a disbeliever, and he used to worship beside Allah, and they were worshiping gods, many gods, aliha, like Allah said in the surah. Oh, I got it already. وَإِذِعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. When you run away or flew from them or escaped from them or withdraw. They withdraw the Shabab, the Ashab al-Kahf. So he will explain more of that. But this was a time where the king was a non-disbeliever. He was a disbeliever, I mean. And he was worshipping besides Allah.
إلا أن تعبدوا ما نعبد من هذه الآلهة التي لا تستحق أن تعبد فالمألوه المعبود الوحيد بحق هو الله تبارك وتعالى.
So these ashab, they were forced to worship besides Allah and worship the aliha, the gods that they were worshiping. They refused, and they made things hard and difficult for them in order for them to worship the same thing that they are worshiping.
كل ما عبد من دون الله تبارك وتعالى فهو باطل ولا شك. فحاولوا فيهم أن يعبدوا الآلهة التي يعبدونها فأبوا وامتنعوا من ذلك.
They refused.
فما كان منهم إلا أن ضيقوا عليهم جدا فرأوا أن يعتزلوا وإذ اعتزلتموهم
أن يعتزلوا. And they were putting pressure on them. And the only thing that they could see is to i'tizal. I'tizal means that to withdraw. to leave that place.
يعبدون من دوني الله. فأواهم الله أو أمرهم الله أن يأووا إلى كهف. والكهف هو عبارة عن مغارة في داخل جبل.
And Allah told them to take a shield or safety in cave. And a cave is, he said, a place inside a mountain.
وهؤلاء كانوا فتية كما قال الله تبارك إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى. ودائما الفتية هم الذين يكون فيهم الحماس والجد والامتناع عن الخطأ وغير ذلك من الأمور.
They were fitya. I'll have to look up fitya in English exactly. Youth, shabab, I believe, but let's just double check. Meaning fitya. Fityatun. إنهم فتية آمنوا. They believed in Allah. And he said, you will find always the fitya, I believe it's youth, having hamas. They are eager. They are eager to learn and they do effort in learning and they are eager in the deen.
الامتناع عن الخطأ وغير ذلك من الأمور. وهؤلاء الفتية مدحهم الله بأنهم فتية. وهم كانوا كذلك.
And Allah praised them to be fitya, called them fitya.
في أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لوجدناهم أيضا فتية. يعني الذين نصر الله بهم هذا الدين الزبير بن العوام.
And he said, if you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, you will find also fitya, those who gave victory to this deen, who fought for this deen.
طلحة بن عبيد الله, سعد بن أبي وقاص, علي بن أبي طالب, معاذ بن جبل, زيد بن ثابت, ومصعب بن عمير وغيرهم.
He's naming some of them. They were youth, young. They were not above even. They haven't reached above 20.
سعد بن أبي وقاص, كما قالوا أكبر واحد فيهم 17 سنة.
سعد بن غوا ابن القوقاس. He was the oldest of them, and he was just 17 years old.
الزبير وطلحة 15 سنة. علي 10 سنوات.
زبير, طلحة, علي 20 years old.
معاذ بن جبل بالعشرينات. وهكذا شباب.
They were shabab. So yes, fitya, I believe, is shabab, young people. They were shabab. Those who gave victory to our deen, who made their effort for our deen to reach us today, and who were eager to protect it, they were only shabab, fitya.
كلهم حماس. ثم جاء هذا الدين الذي ضبط أقوالهم وأفعالهم فانسجمت مع مراد الله تبارك وتعالى. فالفتية دائما هم عماد هذا الدين. ولذا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استخدم هؤلاء الفتية. فأرسل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذا إلى اليمن يعلم الناس الدين.
And he said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, these are the ones who collected and protected the deen and he reached us today. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to use them for good. So he sent معاذ بن جبل to Yemen to teach the people the deen.
وأرسل عليا يقضي بين الناس.
And he sent also Ali to judge between people.
وأرسل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أسامة على جيش وعمره 16 سنة.
16. And Ubayd, I think he said, he was 16 when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent him with an army.
وأرسل مصعب بن عمير إلى المدينة يعلمهم دين الله تبارك.
And he sent مصعب to Medina to teach them the deen. I didn't take any notes, by the way. I have to do it because this was so interesting.
تعالى وقال عن الزبير حواري الزبير وهو أول مرة من ضرب بسيف في سبيل الله وسعد بن أبي وقاص أول مرة ما سهم في سبيل الله وهكذا هؤلاء الفتية يعني جعل الله تبارك وتعالى قيام الدين العظيم على أيديهم. سعد بن معاذ أسلمت الأوس جلها أو أكثرها على يديه.
Sa'd ibn Waqas, I think he said, I have to write this everything down. I will do it, inshallah, and put it in this book. He said, the tribe Wais, I think he said, they all converted to Islam, يعني بفضلillah, thanks to Allah first, but then on because of him.
رضي الله عنه كان صغيرا مات عمره بالثلاثين.
And he passed away when he was in his 30s.
لما توفي رضي الله عنه وأسلمت الأوس كلها أو قريب من كلها على يديه رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. فهؤلاء الفتية كهؤلاء الفتية الذين أخبر عنهم الله جل وعلا في هذه السورة.
We will stop there, inshallah, so because there are so many important companions that we need to write down and know what they did and inshallah who they were. And he said these people, these shabab that we were talking about, Zubayr, Sa'ad, Mu'ad ibn Jabal, radiallahu anhum, may Allah be pleased with all of them. These are the same fitya as Ashab al-Kahf that went or withdrew from worshipping anything else besides Allah. So we will stop here and we will continue inshallah because it's 20 minutes. I'm trying to keep the lessons short inshallah. So see you next Friday inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.